17 kinds of planets exist in our universe. One is normal and habitable, and the rest are extraordinarily weird or purely terrifying. One such space body is Pluto, a dwarf planet lurking somewhere in the solar system. But Pluto wasn't always that bad, or so we thought. Years ago, Pluto was considered a planet, but it was the most controversial of them all. In 2006, the International Astronomical Union declared Pluto a dwarf, and the textbooks had to be updated. That same year, NASA launched a New Horizons space probe to perform a flyby study of the Pluto system and the Kuiper Belt. This mission was taking a lot of time and yielded little results. NASA still didn't know what was on Pluto. On July 14, 2015, after 9 years of drifting, NASA's New Horizons spacecraft drifted past Pluto. They provided the first close-up images of this mysterious and controversial world. It was nothing like what was expected. The photos were stunning even to the most imaginative mind and showed the most complex, diverse, and wondrous terrain. The images from New Horizons reshaped how researchers viewed Pluto and introduced new concepts about the dwarf planet. Now the question is, what did the spacecraft probe see and discover during its flyby across Pluto? What does this discovery mean to mankind and the universe at large? Grab your popcorn and get ready as we reveal what was hidden from the world by nature and is now bared open by science. First, let us do a little throwback on Pluto. Pluto is the biggest known dwarf planet so far in the solar system and lies in a strange part of the Milky Way called the Kuiper Belt, far beyond Neptune's orbit. Like the asteroid belt, the Kuiper Belt contains remnants from the solar system's early history. It too has been sculpted by a huge planet, however, it is more of a thick disk than a narrow belt. The most crowded region of the Kuiper Belt is between 42 and 48 times the distance between Earth and the Sun. This belt is thought to contain thousands of objects larger than 62 miles in diameter and billions of smaller objects, many of which are short-period comets. The area also contains multiple dwarf planets, circular worlds that are too massive to be classified as asteroids but too tiny to be classified as planets. Although Pluto was the first real Kuiper Belt object identified, astronomers did not recognize it as such until other KBOs were discovered. Pluto is the most distant planet from the Sun, hence its freezing temperature of -387 degrees Fahrenheit. With a 738-mile radius, it was easy for NASA to classify Pluto as a planet until they found out it doesn't qualify as one. The American astronomer Percival Lowell first predicted the existence of this dwarf planet from his observations of deviations in Neptune and Uranus's orbit. 15 years after his death, in 1930, came the discovery by Clyde Tombaugh at the Lowell Observatory. Surprisingly, the name Pluto was suggested by an 11-year-old girl and gotten from the Roman god of the underworld. NASA's mission wasn't accomplished until 2015, when NASA's probe made a flyby of Pluto, capturing images that may revolutionize science and space study. The images show a vast diversity of surface features, putting the measure at a diameter of 1,473 miles. That is about one-fifth of the Earth's diameter and much smaller than our Moon. Upon further observations, scientists discovered that Pluto's surface includes very high mountains with heights reaching 11,000 feet. What's crazier is that you cannot stand on these mountains. Yes, the mountains didn't come from a volcanic eruption in Pluto, but methane frost. Pluto's surface comprises methane and nitrogen ice. These materials are not strong enough to hold the weight of an 11,000-foot mountain. There are also assumptions that the mountain bedrock consists of water ice. Another mind-blowing aspect of the Pluto images from New Horizons is the reflective light rays from the ice across the planet's surface. The beams are a color spectrum sorting to the eye, more like a cartoon image of a world. The dwarf planet's topography is somewhat identical to the Earth's mountainous features. It possesses an ice-rich terrain with a snake-like movement. However, Pluto's landscapes are more prominent and taller, with estimates of a 16,500-foot tall just a shy away from ours. The most crucial part of the images is Pluto's tombow region, also known as the heart because of its cone shape. The left side contains carbon monoxide ice and is smooth. This part is called the Sputnik planum. The heart of Pluto drives all activities happening on the dwarf planet. It regulates its orbiting and controls the atmospheric conditions of the dwarf planet. The images of Pluto's Sputnik planum suggest that the dwarf planet is very young, not more than 100 million years. NASA has concluded that the Sputnik planum resulted from geologic processes due to the absence of meteorite impact craters. Contrary to the belief that Pluto is inert, these photos show many activities in this distant world. The best aspect of Pluto would be its mountainous glaciers, dunes, and icy terrains. In the images, you can see dark lines miles long going along the same direction. These lines are due to harsh wind across the icy plain, causing wear and tear. They are also evidence of very complex organic molecules on Pluto's crust. For a planet almost completely covered in layers of ice, some assumptions are that Pluto might have a subsurface ocean, and the images suggest so. However, it might also be rock movements or a thick layer of ice. Such is the mystery of the Pluto dwarf planet, and if Pluto does have a liquid ocean, there is a possibility that life might be able to grow. Almost all of the planets orbit the Sun in nearly perfect circles, but Pluto is extraordinary. It travels in an oval form, with the Sun nowhere near the middle. Pluto's orbit cycle is erratic, which may be due to the retrograde nature of its rotation. It is 3.7 billion miles away from the Sun, making studying it hard. Sometimes it can come closer to the Sun and thaw a little ice to release nitrogen and a little methane gas. Pluto has beaten Neptune to become the planet farthest from the Sun. Scientists get a rare chance to study this distant and cold world whenever it orbits near Neptune. Its low gravity causes a high altitude, much higher than Earth's. It is a surprise how Pluto retains its atmosphere and experiences strong wind at such a high altitude. Not only does it have an atmosphere, but the atmosphere also comes in bright varieties due to gravitational waves or air over its mountains. However, its atmosphere is weak and too thin to encourage the flow of liquids. An image from New Horizons shows a frozen lake at the tombow region. This lake proves that maybe Pluto had a thicker atmosphere in the past. Before NASA's discovery, scientists had always assumed that Pluto has three moons: Charon, Styx, and Kerberos. But the final photographs show two additional moons, Nix and Hydra. The images show the presence of canyons on the surface of the moon. Most of these canyons go as deep as 6 miles, with cliffs and troughs bordering them stretching up to 600 miles. The moon's surface suggests it is geologically active and young, due to its lack of craters. There is evidence of surface landslides, which will be a first-time experience around the Kuiper Belt. Considering all of these features, Pluto's moon might have the ability to cause geologic changes to itself. The two new moons, Nix and Hydra, have an estimated 26 miles and 34 miles long and 20 miles and 70 miles wide, respectively. Among the five moons, the largest is Nix. While the Hydra surface has ice covering it, astronomers still need clarification on what is on the other surfaces. This number of moons escalates the debate about Pluto as a planet. One theory holds that the formation of Pluto might have been due to a collision between a nascent Pluto and a giant obstacle creating Charon and Pluto. The rest of the moons might have come around due to the same clash. Principal investigator Alan Stern from Southwest Research Institute could not hold his excitement and stated, "It is clear to me that the solar system saved the best for last. It is evident that no other planet so far holds a candle to the surface excitement this world has to offer. The photos from New Horizon open a path to understanding other planets around our solar system." After its flyby past Pluto, New Horizon also went by Arrokoth. arrokoth is an object around the Kuiper belt, and the photos show Kuiper as a contact binary. That means two entities merged with the Kuiper belt. Pluto continues to reorient itself, and we are yet to see the last of this magnificent world and all it has to offer.